We're live cage side for the first National Tug and Rumble.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event.
Gentlemen, get your feathers ready. The first pitch to crack a smile loses. I want a clean bout. Touch butts.
Let's get ready to rumble!
From Latin Mexico, at 312, Juan John Sprocket! Okay, that's about basically the sign you're insane, is that you, listening to a Jacques Jams clip on a Saturday, trying to come up with a funny idea about a tug and rumble. That's about the definition of insanity, although I did see a couple online who had a Disney wedding. Apparently you can get a Disney wedding. For $180,000, you can get a moderate Disney wedding for up to 50 guests. That includes a pumpkin ride to the castle. You can upgrade to a glass pumpkin if your heart desires. And it also it does not include appearance by Mickey Mouse. For $1,600, Mickey Mouse will appear for 30 minutes. He doesn't speak, but he will appear. For another $1,600, you can get Minnie Mouse. The whole reason I want to do this, I just want to set my parents up like at Universal, or I mean at Disney, and not tell them I'm getting married or anything, and then just have all the trumpets bum ba ba bum and the red carpet roll out, and this glass pumpkin carriage clip-clop down toward the castle, and so suddenly it catches their attention, and my dad takes out his camera because he's a photographer and inadvertently captures his eldest son stepping out of a pumpkin in a prince costume, devoting his life to a woman in Mickey Mouse ears. I think they would just keep going. They would think that's part of that Disney act. Oh, that must be a Disney play. That can't possibly be the last thing I'd expect. For $2,400, Mickey will actually touch your wife. And for $3,600, Mickey will stay the night in the honeymoon suite after the wedding. I don't know if the honeymoon suite is in the castle. Which room is Rapunzel in? Actually, I'd really want to find Rumpelstiltskin. Do they all stay in the Disney castle? Is he a guy, Rumpelstiltskin? Was he a hero? What did he do? Rumpelstiltskin, gold. He spins straw into gold. But was he a hero? What's the difference? Like, Robin Hood's a hero. Robin Hood steals from the rich and gives to the... Is Peter Pan a hero? What's the difference between Peter Pan and Robin Hood? Too much green felt involved in certain heroes. I think you gotta have two names to be a hero, though. There's like Peter Pan, there's Robin Hood, Captain Hook. I don't know any superheroes with one name, like Batman or Superman. Well, Superman. That's one word. Iron Man, two words. Okay, I guess you can be a superhero with one name. But there's not many superheroes named Christopher. Again, Christopher Robin, who is he? All these names from my childhood, was he a hero? They should not be teaching kids Aesop's fables and folklore when I can barely tell you how World War I started, or can you believe I think the wildest thing probably we've come up with as a society, this is the first thing too, when we instill democracy in Iraq and we're teaching them the history, we should tell them about the Three-Fifths Compromise. Do we realize that once black people had the right to vote, we gave them three-fifths of a vote. We gave them three-fifths of a vote. So two black people would get the equivalency of 1.1 vote. I don't even know where to go from this. Like, my brain just felt like a mushroom cloud went off. I don't know how to describe the three-fifths compromise to you. But like at the time, it's like whatever society presents us with, we're okay with. Hey, how about the three-fifths compromise? We're going to give, you know how we stopped owning black people and making them do all the work for us? Yeah, well, now we're going to give them freedom. You know, just, yeah, it's in the news. We're going to give them freedom. And then I think we're going to give them three-fifths of a vote. Wait. I understand all the rest. What does three-fifths of a vote have to do with anything? Well, I don't know. That's just what they decided on. Like, how? At what point do you get... Are there people at their home listening on the radio? Yeah. Three-fifths of a vote. That sounds right. Oh, did you hear about the new three-fifths of a compromise? Like, that only can exist because there was no media and television and radio. Like, if we got rid of media, television, and radio, I wouldn't doubt that all these things would come back. If there was the internet back then, hey, breaking news, the three-fifths compromise has passed. Black people get three-fifths of a vote during the election. There would be an uproar. But it's U.S. history. We planned this. The greatest minds of the government said, all right, here's how we'll fix it. Here's how we're going to create equality. They looked at the Declaration of Independence. They looked at the Constitution. They recited the phrases, all men are created equal. And then they decided that because of the color of someone's pigment tone, they will get, that's how many times they can vote for the president. Fairly simple logic. I think they should once they should broadcast that on the news again and see how it works. Oh, by the way, you were going to institute some U.S. policy and go with the 3/5 compromise. I think I made my point, but I would love to see that logic apply today. It's a slippery slope. What you get away with. It's how did that ever happen? It's like, am I way smarter than Daniel Boone? Like, I gotta be smarter than Johnny Appleseed. And for all the reading Lincoln did, I mean, he doesn't know what I know. And I think we could do a lot better. I think if I was alive now and they just transported me back to those days, I would be president. But it's just a matter of the times. Just like I said earlier about the invention of the wheel, I was born too late to invent the wheel. A round shape that rolls and, like, change revolutionizes the world. If I was alive then, I would have thought, hey, let's not pull the square shape, let's pull the round shape. I don't care what you think, oh, Steve, that's stupid, anyone could have thought that. No, I think outside the box, and they're all trying to roll a box. I would have rolled the wheel. Steve Rossi, the sky's the limit.